Hey everybody, it's Naya. Welcome back to Naya Reads and Smiles. If you could see here, I have a friend. I have been seeing all over Bookstagram and all over BookTube people getting library cards. I think they are a brilliant idea. Recently, if you guys know, I've been in a little bit of an epidemic because I have officially like absolutely maxed out my bookshelves. If you guys can tell, like, ooh, girl. I don't know if you can tell, but they've started to warp and bend downward, which really isn't good. Decided to get a library card, and you guys, okay. So like I went on Amazon thinking these things were gonna be like 20 bucks or something. Turns out they're like $80. I was not about to pay $80. I did a little perusing and I found this guy here. If you guys can see it, it looks like a shelf. It holds like a shelf. It's metal like the library cards. It doesn't have the lip in the front, which I actually kind of like because you can see the full spine. Can you guess how much this guy was? $30. I think technically it's a utility cart, but the details aren't important. Listen, it holds books, it has wheels, it moves around. As far as I'm concerned, it's a library card. So all of these are my top TBR books. These are all the books I plan on reading this summer and just hopefully before fall rolls around again. Okay, the first book I put on here is one that has been on my list probably since I first got it. The Strangest Dreamer by Lainey Taylor. This is probably the most highly recommended book that you guys recommend to me. I know Lainey Taylor is known for having these really like crazy out there fantasy, high fantasy books. I remember reading her first book, Smoke and Bone. Wait, what was it called? You guys know it has like the red cover with like the eye on it. I read that way back when I was like 14 and it was so weird, but it was really good. It had like chimeras in it. Then I have The Diviners. I don't even need to like, it's embarrassing that I haven't read this at this point. And then I have Frankly in Love by David Yoon. This book does not come out until September. It is an ARC. I actually have another copy, but it's kind of like a personalized copy, so I'm kind of keeping it on like my top shelf. It is a romance coming of age story and it has a Korean American main character. Ghost of the Shadow Market. You guys already know I was gonna put this on my TBR shelf. I might read this before Strange the Dreamer, actually, just because I don't want to get spoiled. And Cassandra Clare is just one of those authors that like people start talking as soon as a book of hers comes out. Another book I recently hauled, The Near Witch by Victoria Schwab, one of my favorite authors of all time. It's actually Victoria Schwab's very first book. I've talked about it a ton already. Then I put Mistborn by Brandon Sanderson. I started this book way back during Booktubeathon 2018, I think. I only got 100 pages in and it was so good, but it was definitely like a very high fantasy book and it was a little bit slow paced in the beginning. Never got around to finishing it. I have the other two books in the Mistborn series, or is there only three? I think it's only a trilogy. I may be wrong. Everyone always comments like, how have you not read Mistborn? Like, as a fantasy lover, it is your duty to read Brandon Sanderson. So I have not read anything by him yet. So this will be a first. Believe it or not, I have never read any of the Aragorn books. And I watched the movies. I love the movies. I was only 8 or 9 when the movies came out. So I didn't even know it was based off a book series. Used copy that I got for like $2 either at a library sale or on thriftbooks.com. Not sure which one. Really want to get into the Aragorn series. Next book I have is Girls with Sharp Sticks by Suzanne Young. I read The Program by Suzanne Young way back. This is one of her newest books and it's a psychological thriller and it takes place at a boarding school and there's like a murder. For anyone who's been following me on Instagram, you know I have been in such a thriller mood. I've read two thrillers. Both of them were fantastic. I will be updating soon. They were adult thrillers. What I have here is a really tiny book. I believe I got this next book like 2 months ago. It is a tiny little book by Angela Davis. Freedom is a Constant Struggle, Ferguson, Palestine, and the Foundation of a Movement. The Kingdom by Jess Rothenberg, another book I recently hauled. The theme park, and we're following an android hybrid human girl who works as like a princess in this theme park. Kind of reminds me of like Westworld, but I'm not sure if it's gonna be as dark as Westworld. And the last two books on my top shelf are books that I have not finished yet. These are not books that I DNF. These are just books that I put down and picked up other books and just never never went back to them. The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss, I still only have like 150 pages left of this book, you guys. So good, and I'm doing that thing, which I always do with books I really, really enjoy, and that's where I just put off the ending. Patrick Rothfuss didn't finish this series, apparently. I think there's one other book after this one, and there's supposed to be a last book in the trilogy that people have been waiting like 10 years for. So when everybody told me that, I really, really, kind of freaked out and just like really slowed my pace with reading this book, because I'm like, okay, there's only gonna be one more book after this and then I'm just gonna be left on a cliffhanger, so might as well just like stretch out the suspense as long as possible. My goal is to finish it this month, so I am putting it on the shelf. Another book that I did not finish that is officially out, I believe. If you guys remember, I started reading this book right when Queen of Air and Darkness by Cassandra Clare came out. I have a vlog that I'll link up here if you guys want to check it out. It was like the worst timing. As soon as that book came out, I put this one down and just never picked it back up because I was just fully in my Cassandra Clare fangirl state. So anyways, I do want to finish it. It's Middle Game by Shauna McGuire, who is one of my favorite authors. She wrote the Wayward Children series. This book was crazy. It was like Greek philosophy meets alchemy meets like mad scientist meets like Frankenstein. It's really hard to describe. It's kind of a mind twister. I was like halfway through the book and still had no idea what was going on, but like in a good way, you know? Okay, on to the second shelf. The first book I have here is Fangirl by Rainbow Rowell. I have already read Fangirl. I have read Carry On. I am a huge fan. And thank you guys, everyone who corrected me and told me that Wayward Sons is coming out this year in October and not next year. I don't know why I thought it was coming out spring of next year. I don't know. I think I got it confused with another book. Fangirl. Okay, I have to do a reread before Wayward Sons comes out, and I know I have several months before then, but I want to put this on my shelf because I know I'll forget and then Wayward Sons will come out and I'll be like, oh hey. I also put The Last Bus to Everland on here, and this is sort of a Peter Pan retelling, and you guys know I love retellings. The next book is Furyborn, which I don't know why I put this on here because it's not supposed to be on here. If you guys can see at the very bottom, I have Kingsbane, which is the second book to this series, and I meant to only put the sequel. So yeah, I'm gonna take this off. I'm just gonna toss it to the side. The next book is Molokai by Alan Burnett, and this is a book that takes place on Molokai, which is one of the Hawaiian islands where I'm from, and I am so excited because it is based on a true story. I actually bought this book when I was on Molokai to visit my family for a family reunion. For anyone who doesn't know, when the missionaries first came to the Hawaiian Islands, they brought with them a lot of diseases and sicknesses. One of the things was leprosy, which ended up wiping out. So sad. Please, please look it up because very few people know about it. It's the reason why there's very few Hawaiian people left now, because so many of us died. We were very isolated in the Pacific Ocean and really had no contact with anybody except other islands. And then all of a sudden, you know, we got all these sicknesses and plagues from Europe that came and just killed everyone. The people that had leprosy, they were sent to Kalaupapa. There's a giant mountain on one side and a cliff on the other side. I actually have pictures. I'll insert them if you guys want to see. I actually hiked down. They're sent to this little town, and it was basically a death sentence for them. This book, we're following a girl who's sent to Kalaupapa, a quarantine area. We're following her life. She's only 16. I haven't read it just because I have family members that were living during this time. It's just, it's like a really like, it hits close to home, you know? So anyway, so I put off reading this just because even though this book is fiction, it's based on true stories and my own family's stories. So the next two books I have are books. Okay, I read this first book when I was 13 years old. So people have told me that it's really problematic, this duology. And I had said that I love this series, but like I said, I read it when I was 13. So I probably overlooked a lot of stuff that was going on. I just remember really enjoying it, but then again, 13-year-old Naya like enjoyed anything that was like really problematic. Between the Devil and the Deep Blue Sea by April Genevieve Tuckolke. I hope I'm pronouncing her last name right. It's about this girl who lives in this really small town. Anyways, this new guy comes into town and he's really weird and he's like an artist, but like he's kind of like something's off about him. It was so good. Like I really enjoyed it, but like I said, I read it way back, but I had no idea that a second book had come out, and it is Between the Spark and the Burn. I want to go back and reread the first book and then continue on to the second book. The next book I have is Slayer by Kirsten White. right now, this is a Buffy the Vampire Slayer either continuation or retelling. I'm not sure which one. Anyways, it follows the Buffy Chronicles and I am just like totally in my supernatural phase at the moment. I have been rewatching Teen Wolf and oh my god, you guys, so cheesy and so good and just like giving me all the nostalgic feels from when I was like 13 and first started watching it. Then I have The Bells by Donyell Clayton. I have still not read this one. I know I have done cover recreations of the first book and the second book, which I also have on my other shelf over here. I still have not gotten to The Bells and I feel so bad because I just love Donyell Clayton like as a person via like how I see her through social media because I don't know her personally. Then I have Armada by Ernest Cline. Ernest Cline also wrote Ready Player One, which I watched the movie and I didn't read the book, which again, I know, fake fan. Everyone says Ready Player One was better than Armada, but then there are a few people who say Armada is just a totally different, not a writing style, but just a different vibe. I believe we're following a main character who is really good at video games, and when a sort of alien apocalypse occurs and aliens attack Earth, he is recruited to come and defend the Earth because he has spent so much time virtually fighting aliens via video games and things like that. The last three books I have here are all Marissa Meyer books. Yes, I am so behind on Marissa Meyer. Marissa Meyer wrote the Lunar Chronicles series, which I am a huge fan of. So back in 2017, she released Heartless, which is an Alice in Wonderland retelling story. And we're following the Queen of Hearts, who is like the main villain in the story, right? This is her backstory. Like, who was she before she became the evil Queen of Hearts, the off with your head person? Very, very, very much looking forward to reading this one. I also have the first two books in her Renegade series, which is another series about kids with powers. This one takes place in a sort of dystopian future, I think. Or is it more sci-fi? I'm not sure. Last but not least, I have this like tiny little stack on the bottom shelf. This bottom shelf is like 3 inches shorter than these shelves, so I can't fit any books vertically. First book I have on here is Fable Haven by Brandon Mole. I talk about this book all the time, and I want to do a reread of the whole series. Only read the first two books, and there's like 6 books in the whole series. But Fable Haven is actually a middle grade fantasy series. I say this all the time though, it reads like a young adult series. I remember it being really dark for a middle grade book, and I think that's why I liked it so much, because it was like intense. And then I have this book that I picked up a little while ago, and it's called Just My Luck by Jennifer Honeyborn. This is another book that takes place in my homeland in Hawaii. We're basically following a main character who works in a resort. All of a sudden, she starts getting all of this bad luck, and she believes it's due to her stealing things from people in the resort. She goes on a mission to return all the items to all the people by hunting them down and like mailing them to them. She also meets someone at this resort and kind of has like a little summer fling as well. A really short book, and I honestly just picked it up because it takes place on Maui and like very few books ever take place in Hawaii. Next book I have on here is another book that I've already read that I want to reread so I can continue reading the series. Foxhole Court by Nora Sakovic. Now this was a self-published book and it was so good, you guys. Following a group of sort of misfits, delinquent guys that are all on this team. In this book, there's this made-up sport called Exi, and it's kind of like lacrosse and rugby. Like, I'm not a sports person, so when I first heard of this book and you guys first recommended it to me, I really wasn't interested because I'm like, I'm not a sports person, I don't like sports. But it's so much more than just a sports book, you guys. Like, literally, the characters are fantastic. We're following our main character, Neil Johnston, who, yeah, he's an orphan basically. The coach ends up giving him this scholarship, and he realizes that the entire team, which is only like 8 guys, I think, all this backstory to each of the characters, and it gets so intense and it was just so good. I believe there's like 2 other books in this series, which is why I want to continue on and finish it. Truth Witch by Susan Denard. I have the entire series, still haven't read it. I have multiple copies of the first book, actually, a fantasy book about different witches that have different powers. Last but not least, I have Legend Legendary by Stephanie Garber. This is the sequel to Carabao, which I read way back in either 2016 or 2017, whichever year it came out in. I absolutely loved Carabao. It was so good. It follows this girl who's invited to this island to experience Carabao, which is like this interactive carnival experience. Now, the previous year that Carabao went on, I believe someone died, and that's the reason why it was shut down. It's opened again, and it's an invite only. It's highly, highly exclusive, and our main character and her sister get invited to Carabao, and it was insane. Those are all the books on my library card. I hope you guys enjoyed. Please let me know which of these you would like me to read first. To be completely honest, I'll probably read Cassandra Clare's book first. Until next time, keep reading, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye!